Many scientists claim that some billions of years ago, a planet-sized object, named Theia, hit our Earth, and out of the debris of that collision, the Moon was formed. However, the formation of the Moon is a scientific puzzle researchers have studied for decades, without a conclusive answer. Still, most theories claim the Moon formed out of the debris of this collision, coalescing in orbit over months or years. But a new simulation puts forth a startling theory. According to this latest simulation, the Moon may have formed immediately, in a matter of hours, when material from the Earth and Theia was launched directly into orbit after the impact. The simulations used in this research are some of the most detailed of their kind, operating at the highest resolution of any simulation run, to study the Moon's origins or other giant impacts. This extra computational power showed that we have missed many important details in previous simulations, and now we are discovering new scientific details. Understanding the Moon's origins requires using what we know about the Moon, such as our knowledge of its mass, orbit, and the precise analysis of lunar rock samples, and coming up with scenarios that could lead to what we see today. Previously prevailing theories could explain some aspects of the Moon's properties quite well, such as its mass and orbit, but with some major caveats. One outstanding mystery has been why the composition of the Moon is so similar to Earth's. Scientists can study the composition of a material based on its isotopic signature, a chemical clue to how and where an object was created. The lunar samples that scientists have been able to study in labs show very similar isotopic signatures to rocks from Earth, unlike rocks from Mars or elsewhere in the solar system. This makes it likely that much of the material that makes up the Moon originally came from Earth. In previous scenarios, where Theia sprayed out into orbit and mixed with only a little material from Earth, it is less likely that we'd see such strong similarities unless Theia was also isotopically similar to Earth, an unlikely coincidence. In this theory, more Earth material is used to create the Moon, particularly its outer layers, which could help to explain this similarity in composition. There have been other theories proposed to explain these similarities in composition, such as the Synestia model, where the Moon is formed inside a swirl of vaporized rock from the collision, but these arguably struggle to explain the Moon's current orbit. This faster, single-stage formation theory offers a cleaner and more elegant explanation for both these outstanding issues. It could also give new ways to find answers for other unsolved mysteries. This scenario can put the Moon into a wide orbit with an interior that isn't fully molten, potentially explaining properties like the Moon's tilted orbit and thin crust, making it one of the most enticing explanations for the Moon's origins yet. Getting closer to confirming which of these theories is correct will require analysis of future lunar samples brought back to Earth for study from NASA's future Artemis missions. As scientists gain access to samples from other parts of the Moon and from deeper beneath the Moon's surface, they will be able to compare how real-world data matches up to these simulated scenarios and what they indicate about how the Moon has evolved over its billions of years of history. Here is the latest simulation about the Moon's origin from NASA.